Welcome to this module on container-based sanitation. In this module, I will introduce an emerging, affordable sanitation solution as an option in challenging environments, where other options will not work, or for low-cost rental housing. I will explain what container-based sanitation is and for which context it is useful. I will then present the case study of Sanergy in Nairobi, Kenya, and finally highlight some advantages and disadvantages. Container-based sanitation is defined as a system that hygienically collects excreta in sealable, removable cartridges, which are then transported to a treatment facility. The cartridges are usually mass-produced plastic containers with or without a disposable impermeable liner. Because container-based sanitation systems are small and mobile, they have low space requirements and can be used inside a home. A number of toilet units have been developed in recent years, including those used by Sanitation, X-Runner, Mosan, and Sanergy, shown here from left to right. They offer the user a modern and well-designed interface, which is important for their acceptance by users. Note that the Sanergy module on the right is the only squat toilet. Informal settlements usually suffer from inadequate water and sanitation services. Lack of toilets and sanitation services may drive the poor to rely on unsanitary and poorly maintained toilets, like the shared facilities shown here in Kampala, Uganda. Container-based sanitation offers a cost-effective alternative for these poor, non-sewered contexts if landlords cannot be persuaded to provide acceptable sanitation or where ground conditions prevent excavation for pits or septic tanks. Most existing container-based sanitation systems separate the different waste streams at source. This makes it easier to recover resources, for example, energy or nutrients. Systems must be emptied at least once or twice a week. I'd like to introduce a successful example of container-based sanitation from Nairobi, Kenya. Sanergy is a non-profit social enterprise founded in 2011, which aims to provide affordable sanitation services for the non-sewered informal settlements in Nairobi. The case of Sanergy is interesting because it shows a range of possibilities that container-based sanitation offers for the entire sanitation chain, from the toilet to regular collection and waste transformation and resource recovery. Important to note is that Sanergy's model is just one example for a number of business models currently being tested for CBS systems. Let's take a look at Sanergy's sanitation value chain. Sanergy has developed the Fresh Life toilet. It is a source-separating squat pan toilet that separates urine from feces. The steps of the sanitation value chain are outreach, marketing the Fresh Life toilet as an aspirational and affordable toilet, collection of feces and urine on a daily basis, the transport of waste to the treatment plant, and finally the conversion of the waste into fertilizer and a protein-rich animal feed. Fresh Life toilets have been constantly improved over the past few years and are now marketed for different user segments. As a franchised commercial toilet with a pay-per-use model or as residential compound toilets. These are managed by the compound residents and landlord themselves. And finally, school or health clinic toilets. Let's look at hygiene. Fresh Life toilets are made of high-quality materials that are easy to keep clean and maintain and include hand-washing facilities. The accessibility. Fresh Life toilets have a small footprint and can be installed close to homes. The affordability. Fresh Life toilets are popular, indicating that they meet willingness to pay criteria. Sanergy guarantees daily waste collection for all Fresh Life toilets. The full container for each toilet is exchanged with an empty container and loaded onto a handcart. The collected waste is then trucked outside the city. The upfront fee for a Fresh Life commercial toilet is about $500. That includes the first year's servicing, with subsequent years being charged at around $70 per year. At the treatment plant, the waste is hygienized by co-composting with sawdust and other carbon sources, which eliminates pathogens. The process takes about 6 months to achieve a mature fertilizer. Two tried and tested waste conversion processes transform the feces into an organic fertilizer and a protein-rich animal feed. The fertilizer is successfully marketed under the brand name Evergrow and is popular with the Kenyan flower industry. The protein-rich animal feed using black soldier fly larvae is marketed as KuzaPro. The protein input provides a quality alternative to existing animal feed in Kenya. This slide shows Sanergy's impact to date, with over 95,000 users and 10,000 tons of waste treated annually in the two informal settlements of Mukuru and Makadara. Let's look at some of the advantages and disadvantages of the CBS approach. They offer an on-site solution appropriate for rental housing and tenants. There is no need for permanent structures or outhouses. And CBS toilets can be used within the household. Above-ground toilets are viable for rocky and unstable soils. And finally, they offer an affordable on-site solution for tenants with an annual cost of about $28 per person and year. Some of the disadvantages include that CBS systems require a well-established regular collection service at least once or twice weekly. It requires secure disposal and treatment sites that are different than for decentralized wastewater systems. It doesn't work for water-based systems for washers. And scale matters to bring down the costs. To summarize, container-based sanitation is an emerging alternative for poor urban areas. Sustainable service providers are needed, and the business model is based on community engagement and affordable services. And finally, resource recovery and waste transformation can help ensure cost recovery. Thanks for watching.